able to deliver the Nairobi the Nairobi Urban Integrated Development Plan, what you call the new plan.
Nairobi is voted among the 100 resilient cities in the world.
Right? Functionality means you don't want to live on one side of the city, say Roysambu, and the only school you can take your child to is in Kawangware.
To build new classrooms in Olympic, we've delivered a completely new school in Mathare Hospitals. We've been able to build a new school in Riruta. We'll be able to build a new school in St. Michael's. We've been able to do a new school in Roysambu. And we are currently just about to finish a school in Kariobangi. We've built close to 100 classrooms, ECD classrooms. We have scholarships for wards and sub-counties, but we also have the Governor Kidero Scholarship, where bright students within Nairobi City who cannot afford fees get fees paid. We are going to do a total of 30,000 houses, which will be very, very affordable, affordable both in terms of purchase and in terms of rent. We will be building bedsitters, one bedroom, two bedroom, and three bedrooms. In the last 4 years, we've been able to maintain and build new roads, a total of 2,200 kilometers. We pushed the opening of the Southern Bypass, so now all trailers are not passing. And actually, the lorry drivers like it because it takes them only 30 minutes from Kikuyu to the airport road. We are planning on building 9 transport corridors. The first one is Outer Ring Road, which is under construction at the moment. The next one we launched with the president last week, which is Ngong Road. The third one will be Jogo Road. The fourth one is the overpass, which the feasibility study is nearly complete, coming from CMC, going up at CMC and dropping down after ABC towards Kabete and Kino. Langata Road is... So these are being built for what you call BRT, bus rapid transit systems.
So we have a plan now for solid waste. Of course, the eventual plan is to turn Dandora into an energy plant where we take all that solid waste, do waste to energy project, and then our feasibility study says we can generate up to 70 megawatts of power, which now we can use to power our streetlights right around the city.
We are now working on a project to start building a new fresh produce hub. It will be the largest in Eastern Central Africa. It will be sitting on about 47 acres. With that happening, it will be one of the biggest logistics hubs for fresh produce. We will be able to repackage our produce and send it out into the Eastern Central Africa region.
We've created 24-hour operation in 22 of our hospitals. We've created a 150-bed maternity in Bagathi. We are in the process of modernizing Pumwani and Mutuini. We built a new theatre in Pumwani.
We also have rehabilitated the same, those facilities. The physical structure has been made conducive to offer those services.
Because for us, it's really a reward kind of system. But again, you have to look again into our history. Yeah. What is our vision? Our vision is to make Nairobi something, somewhere where everybody wants to live, work, yeah, and invest.